you try to be your individuality when the world is on your shoulders. Just smile and let it go.
Hi everyone, welcome to series 2 of An Interview With. I'm so happy it's back. Today I thought I'd kick things off with a massive bang, so why not get Miss Jo O'Meara. Hello darling.
Hello my lovely, how are you?
I'm great, thank you. Can I just say I'm very nervous.
Oh, don't be nervous, I don't fight. Only sometimes.
That's true. So how's lockdown been for you? Because I've seen you on YouTube doing your singing and everything for the NHS, which I think is brilliant. So,
do you know what? I think that's what got me through it, to be honest. I found lockdown fine because I was sort of like every week singing for the NHS, and then I was like doing cover songs that I was uploading to the Instagram and stuff. And that's basically what I spent my time doing. So I found it okay. In a way, it was quite nice to just have some time to recharge.
This is what I was doing in lockdown because I got made redundant from my job. And I always wanted to do something like this. And obviously we couldn't meet in person because of the whole COVID situation. So I thought I'd do this. Right. I do want to talk about...
It starts new opportunities for everybody in a way.
Yeah. I mean, series 1 was an amazing lineup. I had Sean Smith from The X Factor. I had Lolly. I had Andrew Brown.
That's cool.
And now you've joined the roster of my guests, so I'm very, very honoured. So thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I do want to talk about your new solo album, which is due for release next year. Yeah. But I want to take you back to 1999.
Okay.
Where 7 fresh-faced teens burst onto the pop scene with the debut song Bring It All Back. I am, of course, talking about S Club 7. Mm-hmm. What was the time like for you? What do you have any favourite memories of being in the band?
It was a whirlwind, wasn't it? It was crazy. It was 7 crazy kids living our dream, and it was a blast. We had a fantastic time. Yeah, we loved it.
I absolutely love S Club 7. That goes without saying. I was looking through my collection the other day and I thought, I've got a lot of CDs. I've got the singles, I've got the albums.
Oh, that's good.
So on top of the S Club career, you managed to release with the band 4 incredible albums. So we had S Club, we had 7, we had Sunshine and Seen Double, along with 2 compilation albums, which are the same, but you re-released it for your reunion in 2015.
Yeah, we had, didn't we?
Yeah, with the track Rain, which us fans was waiting for.
Oh, was you one of the ones waiting for that song?
Yeah, because I heard it in, I think it was it was Hollywood 7, I think.
Yeah, it was.
And it was one of the last sort of episodes and a little clip, and I loved it. I thought it was going to be on Sunshine.
Well, do you know what? It was only because of all the fans basically demanding that you guys got it onto the album. So
yeah,
it was down to you that we did it.
And talking about 2015, you came back with the Bring It All Back tour. I came to see the last date in Sheffield.
Yes.
I was 8 rows away from the stage, which I was quite happy about.
You would have seen me blubbing then.
Can I just say, your voice was on top form that night, and I'm being honest here.
Oh, thank you.
You know, for your big voice within S Club and your solo career, and I have to say, you are one of my favourites in S Club. I am not just saying that, you are my favourite, Jo. I want to show you a little throwback picture. 2013, we met in Chesterfield at Yates's.
Wow. The hair was very short, wasn't it? I don't know what that look was. I don't know what I'm going with that, but it was definitely interesting, that's for sure.
I still have that picture. Obviously, I've still got a picture. I've still got it in a frame somewhere as well.
It's not longer now.
Because the year after I met Tina, she was in Chesterfield doing the pantomime. So.
Oh, yeah, cool.
So we've touched on S Club 7. Now, 2005, you released your own solo single, What Hurts the Most, which I thought was the original. I didn't know until years later it was Rascal Flatts, then it was Cascada, then I was the U after Rascal Flatts. What was it like recording such an iconic track?
To be honest with you, I didn't know the song.
Okay.
I didn't know the song personally, so I knew it was a cover song that I was doing, but I didn't actually know it before I'd done it. But I thought, what is such a beautiful song? And it was nice to do my interpretation of it. So I just hope that I done it justice.
You certainly did. I think it, I don't listen, well, I listen to the Cascada version sometimes, but yours is the most played on my phone.
Oh, thank you.
I am, of course, talking about your album Relentless as well, which I do have.
That's good.
I do like the title track as well. I can remember you performing it on your YouTube channel. You did like a live version of it.
I did, yes. In the lockdown, right?
Yeah.
Yes, I did. Yeah. I thought, why not?
Because you also did Have You Ever, which you still sound the same. It's mind-blowing.
Oh, that's a compliment. Thank you.
I was listening to it earlier, actually, your live version. And you get to the big note, I'm like, come on, Joe, come on, come on. And you hit it, I'm like, no, yes.
I'm saying the same. As I'm building up to it, I'm like, come on, no. I messed this up. So as you're saying it, I'm saying it too.
I don't know if you remember, but I did a TikTok and I sung 2 in a Million.
Yes.
A little bit of the chorus for you. My voice wasn't on top form. But it's one of my absolute favourite songs from Ask of Seven. Just your voice powers through, and when you was on the tour doing the reunion tour, when that came on, I started singing.
Oh well, that's what you're supposed to do. That's what you go to a concert for, to sing along.
And I can't thank you enough for the cameo you did for me as well. I was the one that got you to sing 2 in a Million.
Oh, that's all right, not a problem.
So after Relentless, obviously we touched on the S Club 7 reunion, the Bring It All Back tour. Mm-hmm. But you've got another project coming, haven't you, Miss Jo O'Meara?
I have. I've got a new album coming out.
Can't wait. I'm so bloody excited for this.
You know, it's been a long time coming. It's been a very long time coming. But I think the break and the gap was good because I've learned a lot. I managed to give up smoking.
Oh, well done.
I managed to get my voice stronger. And I've co-written this album. So this is a very personal album for me.
Can you give us the title of the album?
I can't give you anything.
Damn it. I was looking for an exclusive, Joe.
No, do you know what? I can't say anything at the moment because things are not finalised. Yeah. And I need to wait for the right time before I disclose.
Okay.
All I can say is that I've done it. It's recorded. The vocals are done. The songs are written. And it will be released early 2021.
Oh, I'm so excited. I really want you to, you know, the Have You Ever and Reach. I want you to re-record those.
Okay.
I was like... like an updated.
But I haven't got the rest of them, so I haven't got the rest of the band.
Your version, well, you practically did sing Have You Ever, so.
Oh yeah.
I think that a re-recording of that would be amazing with like how music sounds today, that kind of like pop. It's like modern pop now.
Yeah, well, you never know. I might take that on board.
No idea. I think the fans would definitely love that, honestly. That's another one of my favourites as well.
Aww, I'm glad you enjoyed them.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the album? Or have you said too much already?
Do you know what? There's not an awful lot. No, that's all I can basically say is that I've written it. I've recorded it. And it's in master production as we speak. It will be ready very soon. But it will be released early next year. That's all I can give you.
Well, yeah, I want to talk about your Instagram lives as well that you've been doing every Saturday.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I love them. I mean, like before I contacted yourself to be on my show, I kept requesting on the Instagram Live to come, and I was like, please pick me, please pick me. I want to ask you about my chat show.
I get so many people want to come on and chat, so I just try and get through as many as I possibly can on each night. But every week I try and pick a new face or a new name. But it's, you know what, it's just quite a nice way to, especially during the COVID as well, like, it's nice to reach out and connect with people. And just have a chat and give back to the fans, really. It's just like my little way of saying thank you for supporting me. And in the next few weeks, I'm going to try and jazz it up a little bit, you know, maybe just do some little giveaways and play some games. But we'll see. It's not a definite thing. I'm just trying to find ways of cheering up people on a Saturday.
You definitely cheer up my Saturday nights, because now we're with Britain's Got Talent, I think it's on to the live finals now, but you of course you're on at 7 o'clock, so every Saturday at 7 I do tune in and watch you.
Well, tune in this Saturday too.
Of course I will keep requesting.
I will definitely say hello. We'll definitely have a chat.
Is there any social media links you want to give to our followers to follow you on?
Well, you can obviously follow my YouTube. I'm on there. All my handles are Joe O'Mara, so they're all pretty easy. On Instagram, Twitter, TikTok. I think I've got a Snapchat. Yeah, just write my name in and you'll find me in there somewhere.
That's how I found you on emails. I honestly can't believe I'm talking to you right now for my show.
Oh, bless you. And listen, thank you so much for inviting me on.
You're very welcome.
Keep safe.
I will do, you too. Thank you so much, Joe. It's been an absolute honour today. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you. Bye, everyone. Bring it all back to you.